From state-of-the-art corporate jets departing for distant corners of the world, to smaller private planes whose only real destination is the sky itself. More of what is called general aviation aircraft taking off and landing than just about anywhere on Earth. People have been coming here for more than three quarters of a century, even before they called it the Van Nuys Airport. It started back in the 1920s, when a handful of far-sighted businessmen assembled near the same spot. All they could see were bean fields, but they envisioned something more. They would call it Los Angeles Metropolitan Airport. Their dream would be to build a master plan facility with thoughtfully laid out runways, one that would offer plenty of useful space around it, space that other far-sighted business people could use to build and maintain these winged workhorses of the future. And there'd be ample room for other savvy entrepreneurs who wanted their own businesses to take flight. Indeed, it was a real estate deal the developers hoped would lure people to the center of the San Fernando Valley. The developers unveiled the airfield on December 17, 1928, not by chance, the 25th anniversary of the historic first flight of the Wright brothers. And to get the world's attention, they set up special courses for air races. Then they invited aviation pioneers, daring pilots who were already legends. Pioneers the likes of Amelia Earhart and Pancho Barnes came and set speed records. World speed records meant world recognition for them as well as for the airport that hosted the races. Everything was going as planned. Less than a year later, the Great Depression nearly choked the life out of the dream. So the operators of Metropolitan Airport came up with another brilliant plan. They attracted to their airport people from the one industry that was thriving, the motion picture industry. Then came World War II. The federal government acquired the airport, set up a flight training facility, and renamed it Van Nuys Army Air Base. The military built two large paved runways and used them to train hundreds of P-38 Lightning pilots. In 1949, the city of Los Angeles bought the airport for a token $1 and renamed it the San Fernando Valley Airport. They built a smaller runway alongside the north-south runway and constructed a new tower. The 1950s saw explosive growth of general aviation at the airport. It wasn't long before the Air National Guard entered the jet age and replaced its propeller fleet with slick F-86 Sabre jets. And by the late 1950s, they knew there would be bigger and faster jets that would require a longer runway. A runway that would have to somehow compete with Sherman Way, a major surface street at the south end of the airfield. The solution? Send the car traffic under the runway. The Sherman Way underpass was one of the first of its kind. And at about that time, another name change. It would now be called the Van Nuys Airport. Ambitious airport officials promoted bond measures that would pay for building a new, even larger, parallel north-south runway. And the bonds would enable the airport to acquire land on all sides of the airport. Land it needed for what they would call safety zones and land for more hangars. By 1962, Van Nuys Airport was the nation's busiest general aviation airport. And it wasn't slowing down. The aerospace industry was now embracing the Van Nuys Airport. The airport had nearly completed all of its land acquisition. The safety and runway clear zones were in place, and a new modern tower sprouted up. The city turned the southern approach clear zone into a recreational golf course. And construction boomed all over the airport. Business aircraft, both props and jets, became the newest trend at the airport, with the Learjet leading the pack. Later, Clay Lacy would come along and build one of the first jet charter companies on the West Coast to service the business aircraft industry. The Airtel Plaza Hotel provided a unique place for both planes and flight crews to spend the night, a hotel with an adjoining aircraft ramp. As the aerospace industry waned in Southern California, its footprint at the airport began to shrink as well. By the end of the 1980s, the National Guard was ready to move on. but it left a legacy of memories. Memories such as the Van Nuys Air Show it once hosted. The public aviation display had been born alongside the post-war baby boomers, and it offered the community a first-hand look at historic and contemporary military hardware and civilian aircraft, from props to jets. The National Guard began fighting another kind of battle, the battle against the brush fires that plagued Southern California. The modified, specially marked C-130s were perfect for the missions. But in April 1990, the Air National Guard lowered its flag for the last time at the airport after nearly 50 years of proud service. During its final years, the Air National Guard base served as a backdrop to numerous Hollywood films. It serves a diverse and unique community that spans the realm of aviation. It includes private props, business jets that serve corporations, dignitaries, and celebrities, and restored warbirds. It's home to helicopters that run the gamut from news to fire and police to medical. And it's home to aviation schools that train the pilots and mechanics of tomorrow. Providing many benefits to the community, the airport is much more than a place where aircraft take off and land. It's one of the largest local employers. It still hosts aviation-related events, sponsors educational programs and airport tours, and provides an airport viewing area near where the airport got its start. And it serves as a vital emergency staging area in the event of civil unrest, earthquakes, and other emergencies. Even though they couldn't reap the rewards of their astounding vision, the original developers set in motion a plan for the airport of the future. A people's airport, a business airport, an important neighbor, the Van Nuys Airport.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru.